So I'm going to call to order the February 13th, 2017 Latrobe City Council meeting. Please stand for the pledge to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
At this time, I'll ask for a moment of silence to give thanks, to ask for guidance, or to just quietly relax. Thank you. Roll call, please, Ms. Buck.
Mr. Cortell?
Here.
Mr. Murtaugh?
Here.
Mrs. Weller?
Here.
Mr. Fortish?
Here.
Mr. Baldinari?
Here.
Ms. Beasy?
Here.
Mayor Wolfer?
Here.
Seven present.
May I have approval of the minutes from the January 9th, 2017 council meeting, please?
I move the minutes of the January 9th, 2017 meeting be approved and accepted. Be permitted to remain on the secretary's desk where they will be available for reading and inspection to everyone.
May I have a second, please?
I second the motion.
Any questions or discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously. At this time, can I have approval of the fiscal department reports and paid bills for Monday, for the month of January 2017?
So moved, Madam Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Forrest. May I have a second, please?
I'll second that.
Thank you, Mr. Murtha. Any questions or discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously. At this time, we have our citizens' request portion of the council meeting. Anyone that has anything they'd like to discuss related to items on the agenda, please go to the microphone, state your name and address, and try to keep your comments at 3 to 5 minutes, please. If you wouldn't mind, sir, going to the microphone and giving us your name and address.
My name is Ron Mikanek. I live at 159 Easy Street. I've been up here 50 years now, and nobody's ever touched our street, the pavement. They fixed the holes, and a week later, they're just as bad as they were before they fixed them. When they go to blacktop it?
I'll have to look and see when it's on the list. Mike, do you know off the top of your head? Probably not, huh?
No, sir. I don't have an answer exactly right now for you. When that street's going to be paved, I definitely will look in it. I can contact you if that would be all right. I can get your information after the meeting.
I might not stay the whole meeting. I don't know.
Okay.
I didn't like getting answers right now with the question I asked.
No, I mean, on top of my head, I don't know when that's going to be planned to be paved up there. I know 2 years ago, Eleanor Drive in those areas were paved. We kind of almost bounce around or hit certain areas. We can't do everything all one time in a particular area. But in that street, we try to maintain it with the passion of the potholes, but you know what? As you know, it doesn't last. It's not a permanent fix or solution to the roads.
But, I know that.
But we will address it, and I will take a look at those and try to get the holes at least filled in as a temporary basis.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Any other comments from the residents? Yes, sir.
My name is Ed Showalter. I live at 737 St. Clair Street in Latrobe. On the burning issue, I'm opposed to it. I think it's a mistake. It's just too much of a danger. I have my incidents with it. I had a neighbor a couple years ago set her own fire pit up underneath a tree, 10 feet from my house. My house is all wood frame. It's 90 years old. It's a tinder box. I sat, I didn't know the ordinance at the time, so I just sat on my porch and watched them all night to show, make sure they didn't burn my house down. A couple months later, they started up another one, but I think they did know they weren't allowed to do it, but they started up another one. So I had the phone in my hand, and I said, what do I, just tell them. So I went out, there's a gas can sitting 3 feet from the fire pit. These people don't understand the danger of putting these people in. I just, it's, if you live in town, I think there's just, you have benefits from living in town and living in the country. And I don't think living in town, having fires, is a good idea. It's just unsafe. You know, it's just not a good idea.
I did share your letter that you sent to me with all of council. Part of the thought process, I guess, is that people are doing it illegally,
right.
Okay?
So what makes you think they're going to follow the rules?
Well, because, yeah, because we're requiring them to register.
Right.
And if they don't,
right.
Or, and when they register, they're going to get directions. And if they don't, they're going to get fined.
And who's going to fine them? Who's going to report them?
Well, I mean, if my neighbor is setting up a pit too close to my house under a tree with a gas can beside it, I'm calling.
Well.
So, you know, you have to call 911.
I went out and told her then next because I checked into the ordinance. At that time, I knew you weren't allowed to burn. Mm-hmm. So I did tell them, you're not allowed to burn. But the first time they burned, they live on a corner. There must have been 20 cars drove by that could see them having fire. Nobody ever came to, you know, nobody came. Nobody reported it.
Well, no one reports it.
Who wants to report their neighbors? You know, who wants to be the snitch? Nobody. You want to get along with
them. If my neighbors are doing something that is endangering me or my family, I'm going to report them, and I would expect people to do that.
I mean, I have smoke in my house. I don't have central air. You know, in the thing about calling, well, how do you know by the time they get to your house, the smoke might have drifted the other way. You won't know how do you prove that you have smoke in your house. I just don't agree with this. It's totally, I mean, it's for the few. What about the people that have a 30-foot lot?
Oh.
They can't. You have to be 15 feet from the property.
Then they can't have one.
Yeah, you're eliminating, that's not fair to those people. You're eliminating all these people that have, they can't.
That there are criteria, and if your lot isn't big enough, then
right.
You can't have one.
Well, that's fair to those people.
Well, yeah, I mean, sometimes life's not fair.
Exactly.
So we put parameters in place to try to keep it safe. Well, look, hey, you walk outside your door every day, and you run the risk of something happening to you, okay?
You're increasing the chance of.
Statistically speaking, there's no facts to support that. We've looked at municipalities that are similar to ours, and they haven't noticed an increase in the problem because of these burn pits. Now, you know, if it becomes an issue and people are abusing it, they'll get fined. We can always, you know, repeal the ordinance. But I will tell you, when it comes to pros and cons, we had many more people asking us to do this than not. So I think we were just trying to. Pardon me?
They all jumped off the ledge, but I'll jump off the ledge.
Well,
you know, is that what you're saying?
No, what I'm saying is we're here to represent the people, and sometimes we have to make decisions, and no matter what decision we make, not everybody's going to be happy. So we just try to make the best decision we think. And I think that because we are putting in place specific criteria and fines associated with it, that, you know, if it becomes a problem, we'll repeal the ordinance. Anybody else want to add anything?
I just feel when your fire chief, your police chief, the people that are here to protect us don't agree with it. And you override them. To me, that's selfish. You're just saying, let's not listen to the authorities. Let's just, you know, do what we want to do, because everybody wants to do, whether it's good or not.
I don't think we did not listen to them. I mean, we did, and that's why we put in the parameters that Mayor Wolfer is talking about. We didn't make it a blatant burn at will, burn whatever you want.
They're not going to go by. They're going to go get
them. There are people doing all kinds of stuff that they're not supposed to do.
Right.
We're trying to put parameters on those people, too, and those people still violate. We're not saying let's just do it because everybody else is doing it. We're trying to say, let's, well, it sounds like also I hear a lot of, the people of Latrobe are too stupid to handle this. I hear, I'm hearing that a lot, and I'm sending it back.
Is it related to buildings in town, rentals? I mean, isn't there a huge percentage of rentals?
That percentage is that high. Chief, did you want to say something?
Yes, I did, Madam Mayor. With all due respect to council and their item of the burning, the last 6 months I've been beat up over this by friends, relatives, enemies. I can't go out and eat lunch and sit down at Subway or Fox's without somebody coming up and plopping down beside me and telling me how stupid I am for not letting them burn, you know, in their own yard, and that this isn't Russia, and this is, and I hear it every day because of my stance on it, and I just would extend to council and extend to the public that I still stand strong in my belief that there should be no open burning allowed in the city, regardless of propane, natural gas, electric, wood. I'm strictly against it. I think that there's going to be many problems that arise from this. I dread what's going to happen when it starts getting warm out. And I still stand, and I still would wish council would consider not passing this.
And I was very clear, Chief. I think that, you know, we're going to give it a try. And if it doesn't work, and we get too many complaints, and people don't follow the rules, then we'll stop it.
It's kind of like the genie out of the bottle.
No, it's not. It's treating people like adults. It's still a free country. And the statistics of municipalities like ours don't support that there are issues. We're trying, and I respect you, Jim, and you know that. I respect your position on this. I'd like to give it a 6 month or year trial and see what happens.
James Miller, 127.
Hold on a second, Jim. Chief Brazilli.
Well, on this, my sentiments are the same as Chief Fumar. We obviously know that. And, I understand that the decision was made by, you know, the council and yourself, Madam Mayor. I've moved on, and I understand what's going to happen and what can happen. I was approached by a lot of people, and I don't get too much rest either. Like Jimmy, no matter where you go, we're kind of getting questioned by a lot of, you know, a lot of residents on the ins and outs. I have a lot of people question me, can they build their own fire pit? And I kind of tell them, well, from my understanding of the new ordinance, has to be an underwriter laboratory tested appliance. So all I'm saying is somebody needs to get this out to the general public, what they can do, because they're under the false pretenses, I believe, that they can go out and make this big fire pit out of brick and block, and kind of that's kind of what's going on. That's what I'm getting hit with.
What'd you say, Mark? What'd you say? I thought
you can build your own, but then you have to be the 15 feet from fences, right, and houses and property lines and trees and anything that's combustible. Right. If you get the underwriter laboratory, you go purchase one that's already made, then it decreases to 10 feet to these property lines and structures and fences.
I'm telling you, I wrestled with this, and I still wrestle with it, because I agree, I don't like going against what our fire chief and police chief say. On the other hand, I looked around at local municipalities, talked to leaders of local municipalities who have who've passed this ordinances and have ordinances like this in place, and they basically said they've not had any issues.
Well, my only suggestion, Madam Mayor, is they need to be made aware that they got to get a permit, and with that permit, they probably need to be given a copy of the ordinance and the specifications for building one and buying one.
That is the plan, and that's what we're going to vote on today, correct?
You're going to register. You're running on the registration today, but the ordinance already passed.
Yeah, the ordinance is passed, but we're voting on the registration today, the registration fee, and...
The form for the registration.
The form, yeah. So people can start registering after this meeting, and they'll get a copy.
My only suggestion would be to give them a copy of the specifications and what they are allowed and not allowed to do.
You're going to do that, right, guys?
Yeah, we will.
Yes, Mr. Miller?
James Miller, 127 East 4th Avenue. I've given my concerns about this, as you all know, several meetings, several council meetings, and the chief of police disagrees with everybody up there.
Not everybody.
The fire chief disagrees with this ordinance, and yet most of you voted it in. I cannot understand. At these meetings, we had one individual say, that I was at anyway, one individual said that they would like to burn some stuff in their yard because their neighbor is allowed to do it. That is ridiculous argument. I think it should be rescinded originally to the way it was originally, that there was no burning in the city of Latrobe. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Miller. Anyone else?
Hi, I'm Debbie Hauser. I live at 1920 Sylvan. I just had a few questions about the burning situation. Is it any time of the day and every day? I'm just wondering, what if I have my nice purple towels on the line and someone wants to start a fire and they're all full of smoke?
I don't think we specify time.
Or what if my windows are open on a nice warm day and
It has to be below 60 degrees. That's the one thing but I don't think there was... For me?
The ordinance for wood burners and fireplaces are below 65 degrees Fahrenheit. If it's above 65, they can't use a fireplace or a wood burner.
Okay.
I don't know what you set up for the...
But I thought there was something in the fire pit ordinance as well. I don't have it with me.
It was, that portion was adopted with the fire pit ordinance.
So it has to be below 60 degrees, correct?
Not for the fire pits.
Yes, for the fire pits, is that correct?
It has to be below 65.
65.
You might call it...
That portion was adopted with the fire pit ordinance.
I mean, my problem is I'm so against smoke because as a nurse, you know, I oppose smoke, period. I think it's a health hazard. What about people that have health issues and they have to breathe in smoke? And I always use the example, say I want to eat a candy bar tomorrow. Okay, that hurts me, but that's not hurting you. But smoke is hurting me too. You know what I mean? That's my argument. So, but I'm starting to realize that it's maybe a futile attempt at... You know, a lot of people do want the fire pits, but I just thought I'd put my little comment in there, so I don't know. I know I used to live in the mountains, and when I lived in the mountains, it never failed. Every time I had my diapers on the line or my towels, the neighbor built a fire. So I don't know why he thought he needed a fire when my, you know, when my things were on the line, but that's what my concern is too. But I'm highly opposed to smoke, so...
We'll check on that, but I mean, because I think we're confused, because Wayne, you're pretty sure it's below 65, and Eric, you're saying no? You don't think it was in there?
The original ordinance, fire pit said nothing above 65 degrees. That wasn't changed. The ordinance we have now didn't speak to that. It adopted the same, in other words, it just added to that.
Okay.
But that wasn't, fire pit said...
Yeah, the ordinance was originally for fire pits and furnaces and open burning. Not fire pits, but open burn. I forget exactly.
Never had no open burning.
No, it was for wood burners.
I'm sorry, wood burners.
It was for wood burners and fireplaces.
Well, then we got a problem. You're missing the point. Go ahead.
No, the ordinance itself does not say 65 degrees.
Right.
But the prior wood burning ordinance
That's not changed.
The borough code still says that there's no open...
So fire, I'll go ahead, fireplace.
Wood burners, like inside a garage, a fireplace inside, those were interior wood burners. That you're not allowed to burn if it's above 65 degrees.
If it's above 65 degrees.
You're not allowed.
Because we didn't change the borough code. The borough code still specifies that.
Yes.
Because if they're using a fireplace or a wood burner inside of a structure.
It's for heat.
And if it's above 65 degrees, it's deemed for incineration purposes and not for heating. That's how the ordinance states.
But this isn't going to be inside, so what did, so
yeah, I don't know. I don't know what was changed there. I'm just saying, I know what the wood burner and the fireplaces. If it's below 65 degrees, they can use the wood burner as fireplace.
All right, we'll figure it out. We'll have to clarify and figure it out, but I know that the ordinance doesn't specify a temperature, but the borough code does. Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Thank you.
That's okay. I think it's a futile attempt to say my opinion, but I just thought I'd say it anyway, because I, you know, like I said, I don't know.
It's not a futile attempt. I just kind of wish you guys would have been here before.
Yeah.
Before we passed the ordinance. Because we had zero, maybe one person who was, you know, pretty much opposed to it, and most of the others were for it, and emails and phone calls and things that I got personally, and I think you guys did too, so. You know, I appreciate your comments.
I just always think back to the days when we, you know, like at the hospital, the patients smoked, the nurses smoked, everyone smoked, your clothes stunk, everything stunk. And I can't believe we put up with that. Looking back on it, I can't believe we put up with that for such a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, this, I don't know, I've said to my sister, I've said to my kids, they go, "Mom, you're crazy." But, I don't know, it's just my opinion. Because like I said, you know, smoking, it affects other people, and your things stink, and I don't know. People with health issues have to breathe it.
Yes, ma'am.
My name's Danielle Repko, 116 Wagner Street. I just wonder, where's the $15 registration fee going towards? Or maybe that'll be discussed later.
It's just to cover costs. Basically, we're allocating a half hour, which is a $15 rate, for the printing and for explaining how the ordinance is. And it's just a time, we're not making money, we're just basically trying to cover our costs.
So it's an administrative fee?
Exactly.
Committee reports, finance, Julie, I don't think we have anything. Yes?
One second, let's go just fire.
On what?
One fire. Okay. I got the ordinance right here, Mark.
Okay.
It doesn't say anything about time on it. It just says what materials, the size.
Right. It doesn't say anything about what time. No, I know it doesn't have a time.
No time, no temperature.
No temperature. The temperature's in the borough code. Not the temperature for that, but there is a temperature.
We're in the same ordinance under the normal burning thing.
Right.
We never established nothing on certain days or anything. You guys didn't know online.
Right.
Well,
it's
burning.
Does it matter? I don't think specifically
indoor versus outside. They're two different ordinances.
Well, yeah, I know, but what he's saying is we never abolished the language in the code.
Why you can't burn in your house?
Yeah, the temperature should only, if people read the ordinance properly, it should only stipulate fireplaces and wood burners.
Right.
It shouldn't affect these because it says, it specifically says a fireplace or a wood burning device, and it's inside because it says if you're above 65 degrees, then the code deems it that you are burning for incineration purposes and not for heating. So your recreational burning, you might want to put something in there that this excludes the recreational burning.
Right.
Is how I would kind of, so everybody understands, because if not, then you're going to have somebody saying, well, it's above 65 degrees and I'm burning. Is somebody going to come? so.
Chief, I want you to keep track of the calls that you get. And I know you do, because, you know, after we get through a year of this, if it looks to me that we're getting, that it's overburdening our police and fire department, we're going to have to revisit it.
Every call we run for that is documented. It's in our database.
Yeah. I want Chief Boomer too to, when he gets them.
Well, trust me, when I go, I'm making sure they come with me.
Okay. Well, let's hope that people follow the rules and we don't have a problem. Can we move on? Okay, nothing with finance, public safety and public works. Eric, Julie, stopping, anything?
With public safety, I sent out an email, and then I just talked to Chief Boomer. We're trying to maybe set up right before our agenda prep meeting in 2 weeks at 6. I don't know if that would be good for you, Mike. Chief Brazil, I sent you an email too. I don't know. You might not have.
My phone went. I just got all my emails. I transferred all my stuff.
So we're in the process of setting up public safety.
Thank God for the cloud.
Personnel? We got anything on personnel, Jack? Not that I know of. We did have a meeting within the last, couple weeks ago, but events committee, Jack and Jerry?
I think there's a meeting coming up for Van Split.
February 22nd?
February 22nd.
You run the email. I saw the email. Did you get an email? I'll double check, make sure you were copied, but I got an email from Alan. I thought you were, but I'll double check. February 22nd, I think.
Last Wednesday of the month.
Yeah, last Wednesday of the month. Parking committee, got anything on parking, guys? Jerry, Eric?
We're waiting on, we'll turn it on, I guess.
Yeah, the information's been sent to the state, I believe. It's just a matter now of having the state approve it and then having the transfer of properties.
You mean the disbanding of the authority? Nothing on the showcase, huh?
No, I didn't ever go back to me after, I need to reach out there.
Okay.
I put it where it's somebody.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We need their cooperation.
Okay. Board and authority reports. We had a parking rec meeting. One of the things we talked about was the sharing the police ATV with parking rec. So we'll talk about that more at the agenda prep meeting. Did you see the emails, Jim, going back and forth today? Department reports. Mike?
Nothing to report there.
Chief Boomer?
Yeah, a couple things. First off, we have our new vehicle. It's on the road now. But we are having trouble with our oldest vehicle, the transmission. We're getting that worked out now. Secondly, I don't know if anybody's been following the articles in the paper concerning the state police charging fees in Unity Township, and also the rumors about the Ligonier Township and some of the mountain departments regionalizing. I just want to recognize that our city council and our city manager has created a department here by their controlling me and my budget and allowing a full-time thriving department. We seem to have centralized the Westmoreland County Drug Task Force out of our department. We seem to centralize the Laurel Highlands DUI Task Force out of our department. We've centralized central booking, and I just want to recognize that that's kind of a dinosaur right now, to have a full-time department where everybody works the full-time and all the assets that we have, and how well council and how well our administration has handled budgetary questions, budgetary parameters, and kind of cut us loose to really do our job. And I'm just thankful that over my 34 years here, it's always been that way, and it's probably better now than it's ever been. And I just want to recognize that starting this year, we've kind of been off and running and doing real well.
Well, thank you, Chief, and I'll tell you, I think I speak for everybody here when I tell you that I think, you know, we're very fortunate that we have the police department that we have, and your ability to balance and manage that budget, which doesn't grow much every year, you managed to really handle that well and spread it out as far as possible. I just wonder sometimes, and I think I get a little frustrated with the fact that we're doing a lot of these things for the county and for everybody else, and shouldn't the taxpayers of Latrobe get some financial help for those things? Maybe down the road, you know, if there is more talk of regionalization, this could be the hub of where it starts from.
You look at it from a business sense, I look at it from strictly safety and protection, so.
I understand that, but the problem is, you know, most municipalities run out of money, and that's why they don't staff their police forces. We've been fortunate enough to.
I understand your end of it, and that's why I try to keep the budget down, because my concern is just getting as much that we can out of what we have to spend, and we've been doing well because we've had the right people in the.
Absolutely.
In the fiscal end of it.
And that's a tribute to you guys. Yeah, Jim?
How's the school resource officer going?
Great. I was just with them the other day.
The school just loves him. We couldn't have a better fit.
Good.
Thank you, Chief. Chief Brazilli?
Yeah, I just have one thing. We also added a new piece of equipment to our fleet. We purchased a new service truck, an F-550, and we put a utility body, a custom-built body on it. It has a compressed air foam system on the back, which will help us with a lot of areas, like Latrobe Still, when we get the metal fires and whatnot out there. It was all done with personal funding, fundraising through Company One, our street fair, our gun bashes, and state grants. So the truck was probably about almost $112,000. But it was all paid for by Company One's monies that we were able to garner through our fundraising events. So another nice piece. The 2016 replaces the 2001 unit. So, like I said, it's another nice piece for our fleet and for the community. So, if you haven't seen it, you'll see it around. It's a nice truck. Did you say Mike? Mike got to see it. It was up for inspection.
Thank you, Chief. And again, you know, you guys do a great job with your fundraising, and that helps keep the burden off the city. And you know, we all know we have a state of the art. You know,
we kind of want to let people know that, because it's not costing the taxpayers anything, so it's personal fun, but it is kind of their support that helps us buy this equipment when they show up for our fundraising events. So.
Thank you, Ann.
I have no report.
Okay, Claire, you're up.
Action item A1 is to amend Chapter 257 of the Code to create a no parking area on Unity Street. This was discussed during the agenda meeting. The Department of Public Works is requesting that a portion of Unity Street be deemed no parking so that a garbage truck can pass through the street. The DPW requested that a 25-foot section of Unity Street, beginning at 97 feet east of the intersection with Loyalhanna Avenue to a point 78 feet west of the intersection with River Avenue, is deemed no parking. The notice was for this proposed ordinance was appropriately published, so the appropriate action to take now is to make a motion to approve this ordinance that amends Chapter 257 in order to designate the 25-foot portion of the eastbound side of Unity Street as non-parking.
May I have a motion to adopt the ordinance as outlined by the solicitor?
I'll make a motion, Madam Mayor.
Thank you. Mr. Murphy, may I have a second, please? Thank you, Ms. Beasy. Any questions or discussion?
I did have one phone call on it from a lady who owned a lawn, and she was concerned about her parking. So I got with Mike Gray, and he explained where it was going to be and everything, and she was satisfied with it.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? Ms. Buck?
This is ordinance 2017-6. Mr. Baldinari?
Yes.
Mr. Forage?
Yes.
Mr. Murtha?
Yes.
Mrs. Weller?
Yes.
Mr. Bartels?
Yes.
Ms. Beasy?
Yes.
Mayor Wolfe?
Yes. 37 now.
Action item B1 is to approve the agreement with Greater Latrobe School District for the cost of real estate tax collection. This was outlined by the mayor at the agenda meeting. It's time to set the fees for the city's collection of the school district's real estate taxes. The appropriate action is to make a motion to authorize the city to provide tax collection services for the Greater Latrobe School District over the next 4 years. We're requiring the school district to pay their proportional share of the cost of real estate tax collection.
It's just a motion?
It's just a motion, yes.
May I have a motion to approve the agreement with Greater Latrobe School District for cost of real estate tax collection?
I make that motion to approve the agreement.
Thank you, Mr. Bartels. May I have a second, please? Thank you, Ms. Beasy. Any questions or discussion? Wayne, did you talk to the school district about this?
Yeah, they're going to, I'm going to send the information tomorrow morning.
Okay.
It says it's approved.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously.
Action item B2 is to approve the fire pit registration permit fee for residents. As you know, the council approved a fire pit ordinance that permits residents to have small recreational fires with a permit. This resolution sets the administrative fee for the permit application at $15, puts the fee on the schedule, and approves of the form. The appropriate action is to approve the resolution outlined by the solicitor setting the registration fee for having small recreational fires.
May I have a motion to approve the resolution as outlined by the solicitor?
I'll make that motion.
Thank you, Mr. Baldinieri. May I have a second, please?
I'll second.
Any questions or discussion? Ms. Buck?
This is resolution 2017-14. Mr. Murtha?
No.
Mr. Baldinieri?
Yes.
Mrs. Weller?
Yes.
Mr. Bartels?
Yes.
Ms. Beasy?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
No.
Mayor Wolfer?
Yes.
That is 5 yes, 2 no.
Action item B3 is to approve of the city's participation in G13 with other municipalities. G13 is a committee of local municipalities who meet to discuss various issues facing their municipalities. This motion would just authorize the city to join and participate in G13.
Ma'am.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. The appropriate action to take is just to approve, is to make a motion to authorize the city to join.
May I have a motion to approve the approval of G13 membership for the city of Latrobe?
I'll make that motion.
Thank you, Ms. Beasy. May I have a second, please?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mr. Murtha. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously.
Action item B4 was not discussed during the agenda meeting just because of this initiative recently arose. This motion is to authorize the solicitor to execute the letter agreement prepared by the Department of Environmental Protection, which interprets certain provisions of the consent order and agreement that was entered into by Latrobe. As you know, the city updated its Act 437 plan.
537.
Or 537 plan with the DEP and nearby municipalities. We entered into a consent order and agreement on March 3rd, 2016. There was some disagreement among the municipalities as to the meaning of some of the terms in the agreement, and so to rectify this issue, the DEP has a proposed letter agreement which clarifies some of the terms. Specifically, the letter agreement clarifies the wet weather flow rate for Unity Township. All of these municipalities are currently in the process of reviewing and approving this letter agreement. So the appropriate action to take would be to authorize the solicitor to execute the letter agreement prepared by the DEP, which interprets certain provisions of the consent order and agreement.
Is this a motion too?
This is a motion as well, yes.
May I have a motion to authorize the solicitor to execute the agreement letter regarding the Act 437 plan?
I'll make that motion, Madam Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Forrest. May I have a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mr. Baldinieri. Any questions or discussion? Are we ever going to be done talking about the Act 537 plan?
I think this should be the last one. When I spoke to Zach about it, they're pretty confident this should be one of the issues.
But I did notice that you said this answers some of the questions, and Wayne's shaking his head now. Were you at the meeting?
No, we had, Zach had a discussion today, and an issue came up that we need to have clarified. It's requiring the city of Latrobe to be paying for the green streets, and we need to clarify exactly what that means and what the cost is.
This letter doesn't do anything related to that?
This is simple.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Any other questions? Or, okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously.
The final action, action item C1, is to declare pending ordinance status on the forthcoming medical marijuana establishment ordinance. Now, this issue was discussed at the agenda meeting back in September, but the council decided to put this issue on hold to make sure that budget and other year-end items passed. Recently, the code department has been receiving calls asking questions about Latrobe zoning laws for the medical marijuana dispensaries. Pennsylvania's medical marijuana law doesn't really address too many of the zoning issues. Most of that's left up for the municipalities to legislate. So currently, Latrobe zoning ordinances do not address the medical marijuana dispensaries. So we need to amend the current zoning ordinance, and we need to declare that this amendment to the zoning laws has pending ordinance status, so that the establishments will be governed under this pending ordinance rather than no ordinance at all. So now the appropriate action to take is to pass a resolution which declares the city of Latrobe's intent to amend the zoning code to address medical marijuana establishments and to hold public hearings on these zoning laws.
I'll make that motion.
No. Okay, you'll make this, okay. You'll make the, is it a resolution?
It's a resolution, yes.
But it's a resolution to?
Just to declare, just to declare that
we're going to,
that we're going to be, so we can, so there can be a notice.
Okay, all right, so we have a motion. I have a second.
I'll second.
Thanks, Julie. Questions? Ms. Buck?
This is resolution 2017-15. Mr. Forge?
Yes.
Mrs. Weller?
Yes.
Mr. Bonnery?
Yes.
Mr. Murtha?
Yes.
Ms. Beasy?
Yes.
Mr. Bartels?
Yes.
Mayor Wolfert?
Yes. Let me be clear that we're just getting out of it. We're trying to get out ahead of the questions that could be coming in surrounding this.
Yes. These zoning laws would address things like how far they could be schools or really.
Yeah. I don't want people to think that we're like authorizing something.
No. This is just, there's just a gap in the law, and so just to keep out in front of it.
Okay.
Just be able to do that.
What, Tim? You're out of order, you know. I'm trying to be nice, but.
I realize that.
Okay. I can't keep doing this.
Does this violate any federal law?
Huh?
Does this violate any federal law?
No.
Growing of the marijuana.
Not Spencer.
No, we're not doing.
We're just approving that we can govern, should one, once the issue does come up. I'll let you answer.
When Pennsylvania, they enacted the medical marijuana law, the state did, and so this allows people to grow the small, and they have to be state issued. It's a small thing, but all the zoning laws to say how far, if one were to come to Latrobe, how far they could be from schools, how far, how much, or the hours of operation, things like that were left up to the cities to decide. So this just allows.
But I think what he's asking is, does anything that the state doing violate the federal law regarding marijuana? That's what you're asking, and I think the answer is no.
That's
correct.
So in other words, federal government allows people in Latrobe to grow marijuana?
No.
One license in Westmoreland County.
What'd you say, Jim?
They're going to allow one license in Westmoreland County, that's it.
Yeah.
So only one person who gets that license can actually grow the medical marijuana.
Good to know.
And this isn't for growing, this is for the facility that would actually distribute.
Dispense medical marijuana.
Pharmacy.
Yeah. Okay. Moving on, we're done. Do, wait.
Yes, we're done.
We're done, okay. I mean, unfinished business. New business?
Madam Mayor, Jerry approached me about a parking arrangement on Ligonier Street for handicap parking for Holy Family Church. They had two spaces. He can let you know what probably best fit in the agenda meeting.
Yeah, we need a letter.
It'll be on the agenda.
Talk about a resolution to make the handicap parking, but I wanted to remind Jerry that, you know, to whatever he needs to do for the agenda session.
We now have the last citizens' request is another course of the open forum. If you want to talk about anything that's not on the agenda and that we haven't talked about so far, it's open season on anything. It's been a long day.
Where'd everybody go?
City managers' report, I have nothing to report other than, Mike, you guys, you and your team did a great job with our big snowstorm.
Thank you, Mayor.
I'm hoping that. Oh, yeah, did I skip you? Oh, that's a city manager's report. I'm tired. I'm on my glasses. City manager's report.
I have nothing to report.
And I have nothing to report other than to tell Mike that you and his guys did a good job with our big snow. And I just signed a check for more salt, so I hope that that's the last one I have to sign this winter.
Well, you know what? No, you're going to have to sign two more.
What?
No, no. We're very good. We're below.
That's a big check I got.
Well, we're obligated to purchase at the 60% minimum, 720 tons, and we still have to purchase by our contract about another 160 ton. So I hope we have room to put it somewhere. So this winter's been very good on us, and
it's not over yet.
No. So it's.
And anything we know, you guys will have for next year.
I got to tell you, I was really surprised when I got up what morning that was, and that the streets were even. Well, when the hill was done, I know that the rest of town is good because the hills, takes you guys a little bit longer to get up the hill. But it was really, you did a really good, great job, and people were telling me that everywhere I went. And frankly, I'm sure you guys heard it too. So thank you, and to your guys. And no one else? Yes, ma'am.
I live on 33 Wagner Street, in the whole area.
Mm-hmm.
And in the end of the street there, there's a garage there on the left. But at the stop sign, cars are parked on the right a lot because of the barber shop across the street there on Ligonier Street.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know, how can we go about getting, a no parking? My husband pulled out a couple weeks ago, and he thought it was clear to the right, and he was almost in an accident.
Yeah, there's a lot of places in town like that, quite frankly. I'm not sure.
Where is it?
It's
on Ligonier Street at the end of Avenue, or it's across the street from Avenue A. Wagner Street.
Who's barber shop?
And they park on that side of the street, on Ligonier, that Wagner sits on.
Mm-hmm.
And the barber shop is right below, a couple down from Ross Warcraft. And there's cars there, and my husband was at the stop sign, and he looked both ways, and he went to pull off, but he couldn't see anything, because there was an SUV. He's inching out, and then when he went to pull out, he almost got hit because something.
Yeah, I've had that happen to me there and other places. I mean, there's a lot of places around here that you kind of have to inch out because of the way traffic's barking. I don't know that we can, I'm not sure there's much we can do about that. Chief?
Do they park right on?
It has to.
They park right on Ligonier Street there, yes.
If there's a no parking here at a corner sign, I'm not sure if there's one there. There's two options, that we can go with that, or we can go with the mirror like we did at Sam Saras. But I would tend to think that if there isn't a no parking here at a corner, there needs to be a sign so we can enforce it. So if you want to take a look at that, Mike, just to see if there's a sign.
We'll take a look at it.
Look at it.
Thanks. Thank you. Anything else?
Mike, those people from Kramer Heights were talking about the water going right into the mines?
Yes.
Why?
That was, whenever that, when I was told, whenever that area got constructed up there in Kramer Heights, whoever did the excavating, which I think was Monzo's excavating at the time, drilled down inside the mines with pipe to let the storm water go down to there. At that point, I guess there was no standards on where the water was supposed to go or policies. And so what happened is, over the years, is what I was told by residents up there, is that the mines filled up. So the water level in two of the catch basins were always full with water. No matter if it rains or if there was a drought, there was always water. So what we did is we went up there and investigated it, and we did observe that there, on a dry week, there was always water in there. It did have foul odor, you know, standing water, so bacteria. So what we did is we backed all the water up. We capped the pipe, backfilled it, and cemented it around the pipe, and just eliminated those catch basins. Reason why we eliminated them is, if they're not taking water now, what was the use for? And so all the water does drain to a catch basin further down, which is does have a pipe connected to it, which then goes to Unity Run.
So it doesn't just sit in the mine, it drains out to the run?
Yes, the water from stormwater, you mean? Mm-hmm. From the rain, yeah, it does go into a catch basin, which goes into Unity Run. So the other catch basins that were up there, for 20 years, they always been full with water. And that had probably something to do with the mine being full with water. No one can give me an exact answer, but whenever we suck the mines up, or suck the water up from the catch basin, the pipe that goes straight down, you can see water in it. So it was, the water's coming from somewhere. And talked to Gibson Thomas about that, and they kind of verified that a little bit, but they didn't have any documentation to give me on that.
Okay. Anything else for the good of the order? Okay, meeting adjourned. Oh, wait, I need a motion to adjourn the meeting. Can I have a motion?
Adjourn.
Do you have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.
Thank you.